So today is October 20th, a date which holds significance within the Halo universe. That's because October 20th not only marks the start of the Battle of Earth, but it marks the day that the Covenant found Earth. But by that point, the war had been going on for 25 years. So how did humanity keep Earth a secret from the Covenant? Today we'll take a look at the protocols in place to prevent the Covenant from discovering humanity's homeworld. I'm Colin, and this is Sci-Fi Deep Dive. Remember, if you enjoyed this video, to head down below and hit that subscribe button. So, obviously, Earth is one of the most valuable planets to the UNSC. And, as the homeworld of humanity, it would make a tantalizing target for any Covenant leader. So it makes sense why humanity would want to hide the location of the planet. In fact, they were so serious about protecting the location of Earth that there were a series of protocols in place to make sure that information never fell into Covenant hands. Collectively, they were known as the Cole Protocol. So let's take a look at some of the key elements of that protocol and how they kept Earth safe. The Cole Protocol basically says that any ship in danger of destruction or capture by the Covenant should immediately scrub anything that contains navigation data. Notably, this includes star charts, but it also includes things like AI. Anything that the Covenant could scour to find the location of Earth. So the Cole Protocol was officially known as Emergency Priority Order 098831A-1, although many just called it the Cole Protocol. And for one of the first human naval leaders to enact that protocol, Admiral Preston Cole. But what specifically was mandated by the Cole Protocol? Well, first and foremost, obviously navigational data was completely scrubbed. Any ship under threat of being captured or destroyed would wipe all of its navigational data. This includes star charts and navigational logs, so that any Covenant boarding party scouring the debris would be unable to scrape any navigational data from the wreckage. Then after things were wiped, everything was triple checked to make sure the wipe had successfully cleaned out anything of any value to the Covenant. It also mandated that the shipboard AI of any ship that was in danger of being captured or commandeered by the Covenant be terminated. As the Cole Protocol puts it, the capture of a UNSC AI is completely unacceptable. And if capture by the Covenant seems imminent, the crew are ordered by the Cole Protocol to scuttle the ship. Every UNSC ship has a self-destruct sequence that would have to be activated in the event of an imminent capture. If it wasn't, the crew could be charged with treason. But those aren't the only things that the Cole Protocol mandates. The Cole Protocol also dictates the directions that UNSC ships can retreat from a battle. When retreating from Covenant forces into slipspace, UNSC forces are absolutely forbidden from jumping to another human system. Instead, they must escape at a random vector to prevent the Covenant from being able to follow them to another human world. As such, UNSC ships retreating from battle are supposed to use a series of randomly generated slipspace coordinates instead of jumping to any meaningful destination. However, we do know the Pillar of Autumn does technically violate this protocol during the Battle of Reach. When they retreat to slipspace in a jump that would ultimately lead them to Halo, instead of using random coordinates, Cortana used coordinates that had been acquired from a Forerunner artifact. But beyond dictating the procedure during a retreat, there's a few more interesting aspects of the Cole Protocol. The other one that really caught my eye involves captured Covenant vessels. Under the Cole Protocol, captured Covenant vessels are to be searched thoroughly before being brought into human space. This obviously is a measure to prevent these vehicles from being tracked to other human worlds. This actually extends way beyond just vessels, too. Any Covenant equipment at all that's been captured and is being brought towards any sort of human settlement is supposed to be thoroughly checked for tracking devices and anything that could lead the Covenant to said settlement. Overall, all of these protocols were remarkably effective. They managed to keep Earth and the inner colonies safe for 25 years. So when the Covenant found Earth on October 20th, 2552, the presence of humanity on Earth caught them completely off guard. And since they didn't know what they were coming up against, they brought a much smaller fleet than they really should have. If you want to learn about the Covenant fleet that arrived on Earth on October 20th, 2552, I'll leave a link up here to my video on that. And I want you to let me know down in the comments whether you think these protocols were actually effective or if there's anything you would add to them. And last but not least, if you enjoyed this video, head down below, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the bell icon so you get notified when I upload new videos. So for Sci-Fi Deep Dive, I'm Colin, and I will see you next time.